Hi everyone, welcome back to Vedic Life Coaching. Thank you so much for joining me. So today's video is a meditation for the last full supermoon of 2020. It is the Vishaka full moon, which is happening in Libra as per the sidereal Vedic system of astrology. And we're going to do a little meditation together to see if we can tune into this energy and really make the most of what it has to offer us. I wanted to let you know as well before we begin, a couple of little updates from me. I'm doing great. I'm feeling a lot better every day, a bit better. I should be back to doing videos very soon, actually. I have been working on my Bill Gates video. I think I mentioned that in the last meditation episode. So I am working on that and it should be coming soon. So stay tuned for that. I will be in a new location. I will be in Sydney, Australia, probably recording in the daytime as opposed to the nighttime. So yep, the scene will be different, but I will be back quite soon. So I think what we'll do actually is we'll just begin. We'll just get into this meditation. It's just a nice, neat little one. It feels like in terms of energy and where we're at, and of course the state of the world and what we're going through right now, I do feel like this should be a good full moon for release, for letting go. We're still doing a lot of letting go work, a lot of letting go of toxins, of fear, of things that don't serve us. It's a massive internal clear out that we're all doing at this time. This is a very good opportunity for that. So do make sure that you are doing that kind of work. And simple ways of doing it are, say, for example, getting rid of old things in your home. You know, this can be a really good time to be doing that sort of thing, a bit of feng shui, vastu type work, you know, getting rid of things that you don't need, a good spring clean. This is a great time for that. And if you're in the southern hemisphere like me, and if you're not at home like me, which I'm not, I could clean out my suitcase, but it's actually empty. I could clean out my cupboard where I put my stuff, but it's actually quite organized. So for me, I've been doing all my work I've been doing ever since I got here has been focusing on my health and focusing on letting go of what's in my mind. I've definitely been doing some feng shui in my mind, you know, letting go of old thoughts, old thinking, old ways of being, examining myself, what don't I need to keep doing. It's a brilliant time to take a look at your life, and that's what we'll be doing in this meditation. And one of the things we're going to be doing in this meditation is refocusing our eyes a bit so that what we manifest once this is all done and things start to normalize, and I do envisage a slow normalizing phase. I think things are going to take time to normalize, even if on the news they announce, hey, lockdown's over and it's all fine. You know, I have a feeling that people are going to want to take things slowly, and I think that's going to be wise. We are going to have quite a few retrograde planets. Actually, let me look that up right now. Might as well, because I haven't looked too much at the astrology. Let's have a look. May 5th, yep, that's today. Let's have a look who's in retrograde. Okay, Pluto's in retrograde right now, but okay, just, you know, click it up 1 week. We've got Saturn in retrograde here in May, and then click up another week and we've got Jupiter in retrograde. So these guys are going to be in retrograde for a while. I do think this is going to be a slowing down, and we're going to get, this is the other thing that we're going to have. You're going to have a second chance to revisit things as well. So if there's something you need to revisit, if there's something you feel hasn't really been done, there's a kind of second chance energy here for corrections, I believe. That's another thing that can, you know, retrograde energies bring us, those opportunities that we can correct things, or we can go over things extra, or, you know, if we're building a foundation, we can really make sure that foundation is strong and ready for the new, right? So this can be a good time. But yeah, in terms of the spiritual work I'm doing, it's very much internal. It's very much looking at my own patterns, looking at how the world is being reflected back to me. And I'm the projector, right? So it's coming out of me and, you know, I'm projecting it out. And that includes what I project out, saying to my physical body, like this health challenge I've developed, which is getting better. And what else? My life, my relationships, the people around me, how they interact with me, the things I have, but also our thoughts, also our attitudes. These are manifestations. These are things as well, right, that I'm projecting out and life is reflecting back to me, right? So another big theme about this time that we're in is taking our power back. We've got to take our power back. Are we going to let the outside world influence us negatively? Are we going to let the outside world have our power? Or are we going to take our power back and refuse and say no? And it is being in touch with that power of refusal. I do think that needs to happen at this time. We need to be in touch with our power of refusal. That's a big chunk of the work I've been doing health-wise, looking at my beliefs, looking at, okay, how have I created the various health challenges? And I've been tackling now my headaches, skin, my spine, everything, lots of things that could do with sorting out. And I've been looking at all these things, my allergies, and going, well, do I need to have this anymore? You know, what's the mental pattern behind it? And you can look that up when you look up Louise Hay. That thing on the internet, Does Your Body Lie? I'll put a link to that below. That's a really good link. And of course, David Hawkins, his book, Healing and Recovery, he goes into the mental patterns behind illness. So, you know, we can be looking at all these things and be cleaning up our houses, be clearing up, be getting rid of things, be cleaning up our physical house. Where we live, our body, that's another physical house. We can be cleaning up our minds, you know, and just getting rid of old things. So a full moon energies are, you know, the moon is swelled up. It's its brightest. It's its biggest. It is a time of culmination. And let's begin. Let's begin our meditation today. I'm pretty sure that's about as much update as I want to do. I'm going to keep it nice and short. I think the work that we're going to do in this meditation is going to be far more important. So I hope that wherever you are, I hope that you are staying well, sure, physically, but mentally and emotionally as well. And remember to take breaks from news. And also do enjoy alternate sources of news as well. I have been. I watched the David Icke and Brian Rose, you know, largest conversation in human history. I watched it live, the whole 3 hours. And from Australia, you know, you had to be up at 2 a.m. to watch that. And I did. I got up at 2 a.m. I had a little snack because I got hungry. And because it was long, 3 hours. And wow, I mean, we are living in extraordinary times. So personally, I love all the alternative media and you know, you tune into some of them and you come out of those videos feeling like the divine is going to win, you know, because there is a bit of a battle going on between dark forces and the divine. I do believe that. And there's a lot of evidence to show that the divine is winning. So we might cover some of that in the Bill Gates video, which maybe I'll get to record tomorrow. I don't know, but that is coming. So without further ado, how about we get into the meditation? So find a place where you can relax and be comfortable. Find a place where you can sit upright. If there's a place, you can also be lying down. I don't mind at all. I never think that's a problem. Some people want you to be upright for the whole thing. No, you can totally be lying down or curled up, or, you know, a lot of people want the spine to be straight, but we're doing sort of imagination work today. So find a place where you really, really relax. And you can have your eyes closed or open for this. It doesn't matter too much. If you've got scenery out of your window that's like a giant field, then that would work really well. But if not, then I want you to close your eyes and picture bright golden light. Bright, bright golden light. Feel that golden light bathing you. It's warm. Beautiful, warm sunlight. It's absolutely stunning. It's just bathing you. Feel the warmth on all parts of your body. So feel that golden sunshine on your head. And we're going to take a deep breath in. Hold. And breathe out. Nice long, deep exhale. Now come back to your normal rhythm of breathing, and we're going to feel that sunlight carry through down your neck, down your shoulders. Just feels toasty warm, really comfortable. Down your arms and hands and your heart, feel it warming your heart. See if you can get so still that you feel the beating of your heart. And find a nice deep rhythm of breathing where you're breathing a bit slower and a bit deeper than usual. And if you can extend the out-breath, that would be perfect. Just by a little bit, even just by a couple of seconds. Don't push yourself. Nice and relaxed. And as you breathe, feel the warmth of the sun kind of being captured by the air and going into your lungs. So that now as your heart beats and your lungs breathe, that sunlight is being radiated out of you. Keep taking it down. Go down your torso, your hips, your legs, your knees. Everything's getting this golden sunshine. And as the sunlight travels down and warms up your whole body, every single cell in your body is rejoicing. It's capturing this bright golden sunshine. And it feels wonderful. There's a feeling of celebration moving through your body. And your feet now become toasty warm. Keep a nice rhythm of slow breathing. It's a bit deeper and relaxed. And it's time to switch on your imagination. This time, the journey is not far. In fact, we don't need to travel very far at all. We're going to stay here on Earth. We're not going anywhere too exciting. Well, it is actually quite exciting in that you're going to be able to work on your focus, on how you focus, right? It's a very specialized bit of work we're doing today. But it's going to help you. The energy of Vishaka Nakshatra is here to help you make your focus become razor sharp. You're going to become a very powerful manifester by the end of this meditation. So you've got this golden sunshine, this golden energy. And as you switch on your imagination, you start to see this golden sunlight fades just a little bit to reveal a field. It's a bright green field that's just stretched out in front of you. There's a blue sky. There's gold and sunshine. But it's this field that you're gazing out over, and it looks familiar. And it looks familiar because it holds your energy. It holds the energy of your life. This field could also go by the name of the innumerable field of possibilities. The infinite, innumerable field of possibilities. Right? So there's a field of possibilities here. But it's a magic field, okay? And it wants to work with you. And it communicates. It says, think of things that you've created in the past. So pre-2020, what are the big things in your life that you've created? And as you think of things, a bright, luminescent flower grows. It pops out of the field and it's a giant flower. Each one is like the size of a tiger. And you think of things and you think, well, I manifested a job, several jobs, in fact. Maybe you manifested a place where you live. Maybe you manifested a relationship. Maybe you manifested some skills. But think broadly. Think of the big main things that you've manifested in the past. And they can be both positive and negative. So you can think about, yeah, well, I manifested a year or two of not having any work, actually. Yeah, that was a rough time for me. So you can think of that, and when you think of that, notice the color of the flower as it pops out of the ground. And I'll give you some time to think of different things. Don't have to fill the field with flowers, but just notice. Notice and observe what happens. And notice the good things and what the flower looks like and what color it is. And notice the negative things and what color those flowers are. And just gather together different things that you've manifested, experiences. It could be all kinds of things. Be as imaginative as you like. See what comes up as well. So there could be times of your life. You could have, you know, a 5-year block, or it could be a month, you know, or it could be a day. You could have had an amazing day. And that pops up as a beautiful flower. And spend a bit of time now just observing what you've created in the past. So pre-2020, look at all these flowers and look at the colors. And you'll see that there are some beautiful colors. You'll see that there are some colors that might be washed and faded, or colors that aren't your favorite. Maybe colors you don't resonate with. But get a feel for what you've created. And now the sunlight starts to vanish. The sunlight is fading fast. The sun is sinking beneath the field, beneath the edge of the horizon of the field. And as it does, the night comes on quickly and this Vishaka full moon glows very brightly, and it's a big moon. It's a super moon. So it's big and it's bright. And it's shining white light onto all of these flowers. And it's shining white light onto you. And it's amazing because the energy of Vishaka Nakshatra is an amazing energy for people who are standing at the threshold of a new life. It's a very significant energy, Vishaka Nakshatra, for those who are, you know, you're on the brink of a brand new life. And it's very exciting, but it's also scary, because as you contemplate all those flowers that you created in that garden, some of them, you don't want to create those again, right? You don't want to create ill health. You don't want to create large chunks of time where, you know, money's really tight. You don't want to create that anymore. So as this light of Vishaka flows, this white, beautiful light flows through those flowers and flows through you, it's working specifically on your focus, and it's healing your ability to focus. And it's renewing your ability to focus. So keep feeling that beautiful white light from Vishaka Nakshatra. It's currently dark blue, dark all around you. But because that moonlight is so bright, you can still see the flowers, and you can see that they've all become white. Regardless of whatever colors they had before, they are all now white. And you are bathed in white, beautiful moonlight. And the Vishaka energy is specifically working to enhance your focus. Now, what kind of focus is it going to give you? It's going to give you the same focus that the great Indian archer Arjuna had. Now, you know the story about Arjuna and how he could only see the eye of the bird. And of course, he was such a brilliant archery student, he would just fire one arrow and he'd get the bird. And that's the function within you that we are cleansing with Vishaka's energy right now. We want you to have that very one-pointed, focused ability to manifest exactly what you want. No wastage of effort, no wastage of time. Going forward, after the world opens up again, for you to be your full self, we very much want for you to be able to reap exactly what it is you want when you launch your arrows into the world. We want that precision. We want for you to put a bit of effort and boom, you get what you want. And I'll give you a bit of time now to think about what you want while this Vishaka supermoon, beautiful white light is flowing through you and cleaning your flowers and cleaning your field, cleaning the infinite innumerable field of possibilities in front of you. As it's cleaning everything, as it's doing its magic work, I want you to contemplate, spend a bit of time contemplating now what it is you'd like to create. And this time I'm going to ask some specific things. We're going to look at what you want to create globally. And this is because as part of Vishaka Nakshatra, Vishaka is a big thing about partnerships and teams and working with each other. So create some collective things that you want. Maybe you want a health system that treats people holistically, you know, that doesn't just separate and divide body parts and treats them in isolation. Maybe you want a holistic medical system that cares about diet and, you know, breathing and meditation. Maybe you want a financial system that is designed to work for everyone and that isn't just in the hands of a few. Yeah, maybe you want a justice system where, again, the power is not just in the hands of a few. Maybe we want to create that going forward. Maybe we want to create communities where there are these beautiful community centers that have, you know, music rooms and art rooms and places to go and be together and be creative and meet other people and make things. You know, imagine that. Imagine a community center where you could make your own shoes, or you could, you know, paint, or you could learn astrology, or, you know, where resources are shared. Right? So you don't have to buy everything. You know, there are great community centers where we all share everything. And maybe there are places that teach you gardening and that loan out tools, you know, like libraries do. Imagine a future like that. Out of this time, we can have an amazing future. Because so many of us in lockdown, we've got ideas. You know, we're coming up with ideas. And as you come up with a beautiful vision of the future now, you are putting that out into this innumerable field of possibilities. You're giving that energy to the collective. And it will manifest. And especially now that you've got this Vishaka full moon energy clearing up your ability to focus. And as you breathe in deeply, breathe out anything that you want to let go. This is an amazing time in history to be letting go, so let go. Let the visions go. Let what you want go. Let any fears go. Let any toxins go. Let any negativity go. And in the coming days, remember to be easy on yourself. Remember to rest. Remember to play. Remember not to put too much pressure on yourself. Because the more you are happy, believe it or not, you are contributing a great deal to the world right now. All those people who are happy right now are really keeping the balance on the good side strong. You're doing an amazing job. Just by being happy, just by being peaceful, just by doing a meditation like this, you're really helping the collective energies of the world right now. Right? We're in Libra here, and you're maintaining a beautiful balance for all of humanity, for the whole, for the collective. So good on you. You know, we need more people like you. And as the moon sinks beneath the field, the horizon line of the field, you see the sun come up. And the field is fresh and empty. So you can either choose to spend more time in this field, or if you like, you can start to come back into the room. Wiggle your toes. Perhaps change your breathing a little bit. And anytime, feel free to open your eyes. And I want to thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned, there's more to come. I'll see you next time.